Hi everyone, it's Helen here. It's getting colder here and today let's make something warm. I will be cooking Vietnamese beef stew bò kho, and this dish is highly requested by many of you. So let's begin.
The final product will look something like this or like this. Are you ready? Let's go. Firstly, we cut the beef into 1-inch cubes. You can use any cut of beef that you like, beef flank, beef brisket, beef shank, tendon, or even oxtail. Because I prefer beef with some fat on it, so here I'm using beef brisket. I'm gonna season the beef like always with salt, sugar, chicken stock, and pepper. Other than that, of course, we also need some special seasonings. If you can buy the bò kho seasoning powder pack, it's perfect to use that. Or you can just use 5 spice powder as I do here. We also need some minced garlic and grated ginger. And even though it's a Vietnamese dish, I'm not using any fish sauce for this recipe because I believe beef goes better with soy sauce. So 2 tablespoons of soy sauce and some pepper before I forget. So get your hand in there, massage the beef and mix really well so the meat is well coated in the marinade. Then we're gonna cover and let it marinate for about 30 minutes at least, or better overnight in the fridge. Next, in a large pot or a wok on medium-high heat, add in 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil and a tablespoon of minced garlic. To create the special beef stew aroma, we need 3 to 4 stalks of lemongrass, which I have cut into 3-inch length and slightly bruised. 3 star anise and 1 cinnamon stick. Quickly stir fry for just about 30 seconds on high heat to bring out the aroma in these elements. It smells really good. Can you smell it? After that, add in the marinated beef and stir fry until the color outside changes completely. You should stir fry the beef on high heat. Okay, so when the beef is no longer pink, we're gonna add in 1.5 cup tomato sauce. You can use homemade tomato sauce or buy the ready-made at the store. The tomato sauce not only adds nice flavor to the stew, it also thickens the broth and give it a nice red color later. You can also substitute it with 3 tablespoons of tomato paste. Next is my secret ingredients for this dish, is the coconut juice. I'm using frozen coconut juice here, but of course you can use fresh one. The coconut juice enhances the flavor of the broth a lot. To that, we're gonna add 6 cups of water. It's totally okay just to use water, but if you can afford, then use homemade beef broth or 100% fresh coconut juice. Add more salt and adjust to your taste. To save time and energy, I have transferred to a pressure cooker here. Bring to a boil and cover the lid. Timing would depend on how good your pressure cooker is. Mine takes about 25 minutes. While waiting for the beef to be cooked, we're gonna cut the carrots. Peeled and cut into 2-inch pieces. Then cut each piece into half using diagonal cut. Or you can just cut it into whatever shape you want. Next step is totally optional. If you want, you can stir fry the carrots with some minced garlic, salt, sugar, and oyster sauce. This will help the seasoning to go deeper into the carrots and make it more tasty. But if you're lazy, you can totally skip this step. When the beef is done cooking in the pressure cooker, release the pressure or let the pressure cooker cool down before you open it. Add in the carrots and cook until soft. The stew already has nice red color from the tomato sauce, but if you want to make more coloring oil from anacardosis, you can click on the pictures to know how to make it. Asian Thai basil and salted herbs are normally used to garnish for this dish. So when the beef and the carrots are cooked to your desired standard, transfer it to a plate. Sprinkle some crispy fried shallots and black pepper on top. You can also garnish with thinly sliced onion, spring onion, or cilantro. There are many ways to serve this dish. You can either eat it with French baguettes or rice noodle. In my city in Vietnam, we eat this with one sunny side up egg and French baguettes as a breakfast. It's kinda heavy for breakfast, but you know, it gives you enough energy for the whole day. Let's have a taste. It's really good. You can smell the aroma of the lemongrass, the fine spice powder, taste the sweetness of the star anise and cinnamon sticks. It's really tasty. You can also serve this with rice noodle, then it is called Phở bò kho or hủ tiếu bò kho.
So I hope that you will like it, and thank you for watching. Bye bye.